It's hard to run a Gucci slide. This is that bitch is nigga that ain't never. I'ma stand up. Jackie Chan, no travel. Can't clean it with the beans. Dripping from the. No, no, not me. I can never be the one you wanna stuff for. Money, money, that machine. Not starting out too well, to be honest. First season as the recording GC on 0-3. It's been some close games. We could have easily been 2-4. The Pittsburgh game was a loss for sure. Excuse the bassiness in my voice. It's going to come getting over a cold. Let's have some money. I do have a few things to do. Work with week 4 and 5 weeks, but if I need to do any adjustments, I can do it now. Let's start with our weekly training. Get this out of the way.
You're just in the car, man. It's like when you're in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you're like, you by yourself.
Everyone needs help, so.
And you're just cruising on the way, man.
Hey, Sparrow. I'm feeling a little better. Congestion's got a little worse, but I'm getting some of my energy back. Yesterday I literally slept like all day. No joke. So it was nice to be able to get all my sleep. My body needed it. I think I slept from Friday to Saturday. Oh no. Damn, it's not my fault. I'll just say that, it's not my fault. I isolated myself at work, so you can't blame me. But bonus is no, I slept for like 13 hours. From like 8 to like 9 yesterday, and then I was napping pretty much all day if I wanted to. Do you want to set up a party? Are you just watching on YouTube? Oh, Sunday. Usually the basketball game right now, so I don't know if you're actually going to go to that. But get better, man. Definitely get better. Hopefully you don't have the same thing as 5 days a week, it's just annoying. But getting back to this, next thing I'm going to do, nice, Chase Winovich. Spent decent money on this guy. Make him the run stopper that I need him to do. Nice, 77 overall. He's not my best player on the roster overall wise, but Sparrow, if you're watching, I moved Dodd out of the starting lineup, put my rookie Joseph in there instead. That gives me
don't want to see me win, man.
If you have a bye week 5, I'll probably just skip directly to week 6 and then leave it at week 6. I don't even know how you got to win, man. I watched like week 2. I watched week 1 and week 2 and like my teams were good, but like we would just like fall off like last like 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Granted, we played the Patriots week 1, so that doesn't help. Spoke to God and me and Satan had a face off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. Hey, you know, if I go 0-16, I'm not the first 16. And I kept an A1 so, like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started spent my money on recording. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put small, but man, that made me a fortune. I think I'm gonna take a look at my roster. I mean, it's my bye week, so. I have to really take a look. Later, man. Get better.
get better. One thing I recommend, get a bunch of emergency. The vitamin C will help you out a lot. That's what the doctor told me. On top of the meds, just take some emergency. That vitamin C will help your body start combating any illness that you have on the inside, and just get a lot of rest. Just sleep, 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 sleep. Because that sleep will help you out a lot. Yeah. Sleep's gonna help out a lot. So, all right, man. I'll message you once I finish week 6, and then just so you have an idea of like where we're at. Okay. All right, man. Get better. Get better, man. All right. Let's take a look at this roster real quick. Alright, I think this is the week that I'm going to put a guy up on the trade block. I got to see what the cap penalty would be. I really want to get a third running back. Because I only have two on the roster. But I need to look at what we have an abundance of. I'm not going to get rid of a receiver. Let's see. I won't get anything for him. He's injured, so that's nice. Oh, KJ Walker's back. Oh, nope, he's injured. Alright, so I think I'm starting Jennings. Let's see. Okay, so I've got five on the block. Oh, I have Joseph starting on the left side. That's right. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company. Let's just go ahead and adjust that. In the scheme, as in case you come for me. In the scheme, as in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they discard those changes. They don't want to be a changing a guy's height. Looking taller than he really is. Had a bachelor's degree. Now working on the self-esteem. Hit a block. Yo, this block. When you add pen it. My new map location. Change your money.
Flintstone bust down, color Maricami. Rudy P. Which allows me to put Dean Logan on the block. That'll put me at like 3 next. Yeah, that'll put me like my 3 max limit.
I got so much beef, I can barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good love, mama praying on the knees all day.
Is there anything else I need to do? Oh, I need a scout. That's right. Alright, so my team pretty much needs everything. So nothing's off limits. I think I'm alright when it comes to linebackers. But, I mean, I'm gonna have a top pick. Let's take a look at. No, let's not go. Need to go with that guy. Let's see. I pretty much have stopgaps everywhere. I'm not worried. I'm not too worried about receiver. We have receiver help. But I'm not. So receiver is not a position I'm worrying too much about. The one thing I'm going to focus on, I'll probably focus on. Let me take a look at my roster real quick before I continue scouting. So I definitely need to look at quarterbacks. You know, welcome. For the viewer that's here, welcome to the channel. We are doing what's called the Jerry Jones Experience, where we get to be owner and GM of our very own franchise. Right now, I'm just going through to see like what my team has with regards to like future, because first year of a new franchise, you're not going to expect to win right away. And I'm trying to play more of a long game than a short game. So I'm going through real quick. I'm on my week 4 bye, so essentially what I'm gonna do is just go through my roster, see if there's anyone that I want to positions I want to focus on, at least in the early rounds of scouting. With that scouting, we only get to scout 150 players, of which we can fully scout 30. So normal players can get up to 2 traits. That third one counts as a fully scouted player. I just add them to the draft board. Let's subtract that 30 max. Because NFL teams only bring in 30 guys for what am I trying to say here? NFL teams only to bring in 30 guys for their in-depth scouting. Some teams tend to scout higher end guys. Some teams, take a look at the Green Bay Packers, for example. A lot of their guys that they scout are, you know, that 4th to 7th round range, which is nice, which is like kind of ideal in a situation like that. So, that's kind of what we are going with. Just taking a look at the roster. I'm definitely gonna have to take a look at quarterback position. There's a lot to be desired here. I'll probably take a look at running back, just because I need a third running back. I'll probably just sign a receiver, just because I'm not worried about, not really worried about anything. I'm trying to find an easier for a little bit. If you always look at offensive line, you don't need that much of that. My defensive line is actually pretty solid. I could probably stand to look at defensive tackle. I could probably benefit from a defensive tackle. My outside line, my linebacking core, all is solid. Could be better. So, probably look at the second line. Probably won't necessarily look at the second line back there. Probably focus more on the defensive line. I personally like a 3-4 defense, but I'm in my position for the 4-3 defense. know it didn't get cash now, we bagging that. Stacking up the zero. Certified corner. Hero. You can try one of them. Corner. Man, I try with me though. Well, it's been some time looking at the position. But I think I really want to, yeah, I really want to devote some resources into my safety. We to the mat at Lana, head cop to the left, turn to the back. Try to see we weren't having that. Sink with your ad, drop it out with Alabama at. That would give a trying to battle rap. Hit, be one and done. No drive, but we running. Walk up to you while you're showing us stunts and you're up that jury and money. Playing game, thinking showing up funny to my young win. What I usually do is don't nobody care about it. You got problem, huh? Well, it's the same thing for everybody. I ain't gonna lie. I promise that a day go by. I ain't on the ground if I ain't on fire. If it one thing I want, it can't go by. Trying to put city wheels on a Range Rover. I ain't finna play no game, but you know something. You think at the top till I move over. What I do is I will scout for the first goalie first. Now come with us and down. And then if anyone has a real better first top skill, I'll go through and I'll scout for it. Middle throne, concrete crown. Call that line, you getting beat. Real, what veteran? What academy? Like, still remember me when they're sick and need their medicine. Better watch your partner, you even ride. Hell, think it's sweet, you got the wrong idea. And even left out there, tell them so what? I kept trap music, all black. Still, I'm that stupid. Still down to do it if you ask stupid. Get locked up and get back to it, yeah. Trap music, all black. Get locked up, get back to it, yeah. Alright. Now that we've scouted, training's complete. I'm not gonna look to acquire anyone. It's advanced. They call a podcast Poppy. King goes, I see they tryna copy. Diamonds in the chains, bust down wrists. And you ain't never seen no like this. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. I be out on a late night. I'm a sit a play fight. See fine break night. This break night. My wrist watch is like a break light. And you can get it right on your gravesite. So tell me something I don't know. $50 pizza when I'm eating in Soho. I heard that you in love with the stuff in your bedroom. Hate me, they hate me. What should I do? Keep getting money. It's funny, I was just like you. Super Bowl Sunday. Put the facts. Security guard told Kevin Hart to relax. Oh! Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. I reinvented myself. They sort of hated it. I reinvented myself and upgraded it. Traded it to jewels. Copped a couple new ones. Lost a couple friends. And got a couple new ones. Upstairs and downstairs, the balcony. The ocean side views, the alchemy. Ain't nothing crazy like the city in the summertime. So when it's winter, I still be on my summer grind. So handle your business, handle your business. Lawyer and honor, don't break the bro codes. The more red rose, max with the rose gold. Whoever counted me out, they can't count. Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. They call a podcast Poppy. King goes, I see they tryna copy. Diamonds in the chains, bust down wrists. And you ain't never seen no like this. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax. Relax, 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 relax. Oh, relax, 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 relax. Oh, relax, 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 relax. Oh, relax, 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 relax. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop home game in the choke call. I'm gonna bring back OJ. Let's see. I want offensive line. I'm gonna get offensive line and receivers. Is there an offensive line and receivers? Situation with corners. Yeah, I think I'm alright. Right now. No, we'd have to run. with what I have on the roster, that base 4-3 is going to be what we run.
Count, cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now. I'm too on one day on my third. I was too broke, now I'm too rich. Made 100K on my third shift. I'm a boy, so boy, and I'm a gangster. And you a boy.
Yeah, I don't see me winning again. I'll be lucky to get a win. Because they have Ryan Shazier, and they have Kyler Murray, and they have DJ Swearinger. They just loaded up on guys, which is nice, I guess.
DJ, all the way. It's a coach. This is Madden 19 on EA Sports.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League.
Ball to start the second half. Let's turn the speed to slow. Come to the end of the game.
The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports.
Pitch.
Gets fielded in the end zone,
right,
and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Cardinals now for their opening drive. And a look here at their go-to guy under center.
It's pretty much become the norm when we see guys come out before a game and go through the route tree with their receivers. I thought it was exciting for us to see the exact same thing happen in practice.
He's so meticulous, isn't he?
He really is, and it's not just a one-time a week thing. They work on it all the time, trying to hone that fine edge. They want to see if they can get in sync and stay in sync in this one.
The
first carry now. This is Johnson, and able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
I mean,
just when you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue line.
On second down, Johnson.
And
nice.
I wonder if Jalen, my defense is so strong that they have
still down.
Gotten.
Hopefully nothing serious.
Hurt.
While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back.
But he is not happy with himself. He'll probably be back in the game though.
Just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and 1. They'll run with a former Tar Heel, TJ Logan. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized. The other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
12 yards there as they move the chains.
I got
kicked out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations. But a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. And here are the offensive starters for Arizona.
David Johnson's play has forced us to talk about him as one of the premier running backs in the NFL. Good size, so he can run inside and break through some tackles. Also has excellent speed, so he can get to the perimeter, turn the corner, and make it into a big game. But he also relies on the fact that he was a college wide receiver at one point, and they can utilize him both out of the backfield and in the slot back position in order to get downfield and catch the football.
Time for a look at our starters here on defense. And they've been excellent against the pass, the number 6 unit in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Joseph,
You never want to give up a sack. Nice. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
On fourth down, here's Andy Lee on to kick it away. Back deep to return is Cyrus Jones. And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. They'll be led out by the former Heisman Trophy winner and number one overall pick from Oklahoma. It's Sam Bradford.
And coming off of an early season open week. Okay. And in this situation, what he told us when we sat back down with him was he spent a lot of time working on fundamentals, kind of getting back to basics during that time, as opposed to having to worry about healing up or resting up. It's too early in the season. Get back to the basics, get his game going again.
And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Second and nine now from the 21. Now Bradford on second down. Looking left side, and he's got him in. It's Higgins. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. And here is the Cardinal defense.
It's easy to talk about Patrick Peterson because you can be definitive about his game. Tremendous against the run because he's an excellent tackler. Can run with anyone because of his speed. Has the size to play the football downfield extremely well. And then you throw in his kick return ability, you have one of the top corners in the NFL year in and year out.
Bradford from the gun on third down. And he finds Seals Jones complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players and somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes. Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It's the Pro Bowler Chandler Jones who makes the tackle.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game with the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. Third down now. It's C.J. Anderson. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It's a gain of five, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Townsend to punt it. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach.
And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. They'll run it now out of the gun. Nice move on the play, but he will be brought down shy of the 15. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
They get all came together there, in breaking route, drove it with excellent pace, money throw right there to move the sticks.
4-3 and go put something on top of that, you're exposing yourself to the mid. You're exposing yourself to not having coverage in the middle of the field. Safeties aren't normally going to come in and cover that middle area, or at least the man. They're not going to cover the middle area.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 12 more yards there and another first down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. It'll be a five-yard pickup there. So from second and 13, they're back to a more manageable third and 8. He's going to go for a big play downfield.
He's overturned the receiver.
On third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
That first down keeps yourself enough of the first down. Or, maybe a jump off at that point. If someone goes deep, they've got to at least be playing the
first down, Bradford. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Oh man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. On second down, Bradford again. From right side, going to be caught by Seals Jones.
Makes the catch.
And they'll get him down here at the 23. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So either he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there. But that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Here now, Johnny Townsend, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Spins away.
A
big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And the Cards will take over. First and 10.
First and 10. Here
we go now. And they'll start the drive of the ground with Johnson. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Good opening corner for him. Remember, he had the sack earlier. Now a tackle for loss, another tackle for loss.
He's really making it tough on the play caller, though, isn't he? Because it's one thing to try and adjust, but a guy is disrupting your running game. But when he's messing up your passing game as well, they may have to devote at least a second guy to him to try and keep him away from their plays.
Touchdown, Cardinals! Christian Kirk, 76 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Dan Bailey now for the extra point.
All right, we're down.
Bailey got the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Here's second and seven now from the 28. On second down, Anderson.
Ooh, he's gonna cut.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
First down. Here's the run with Anderson. Anderson loses the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. First carry of the ball game now, it's C.J. Anderson. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. From the gun on third down, Bradford. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. So we played one quarter here on a Monday night. It's a close game here early on. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Brooklyn football as we get going in quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They give it to Anderson. He'll get only a couple down to the 44.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now Bradford. He's going to be hit and driven into the turf.
But nothing takes a start to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
In search of something here after the sack. It's third and long. Bradford getting his guys ready. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. A dump off to Anderson. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a gain of 5 on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Here now, Johnny Townsend, as he's on to kick it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And now let's look at David Johnson. Whatever he was doing in September, they're hoping that that carries over now to October because he was sensational last month.
He absolutely was, and we all know where it started, at the end of last season. right? All the offseason preparation, the weight workouts, the sprints, right? The vision that he had, what he was going to do this season. And, of course, it all came together.
And Owen caught it up. And this is picked up by the defense. And they'll be at the 18-yard line. Great field position here in the red zone. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. The results for them so far, not that great. Well, not good at all. Three drives, three punts.
Yeah, and now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet, trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off? Or do they just have to go to a different play calling section and try and run some offense that way?
Johnson, and they'll get him down here at the 23. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. I actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner, but I do think they've been able to do that, maybe not as effectively as they've wanted to, but I think we'll see more of as this game goes along, because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
First with Johnson. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Hurry up, here we go. 3, 9, 10.
Off play action. Murray. And this one caught by Max Williams. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 13 yards on his first catch. It's a first down as well.
Nice idea, nice concept there. Line him up on the left side of the formation. Let him sneak his way across. Coming back underneath. Put it in his hands. Let him get a few more yards after the catch, too.
Great way to utilize a tight end on the drag route. Tenth carry for Johnson, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
All right, here we go. 3, 19.
Now a handoff, Johnson. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done. That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Here's Murray. Wilson snags it left side. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. That good for 6 as they keep this drive right on rolling.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Here we go.
They run with Logan. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Defensively, Sam Hubbard, the former Buckeye, there to stop him.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To throw on second down, Murray. He's going to have the hook up to Gage. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 at a first down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness is a premium for all of that now.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He's able to rattle off six on the carry, and that'll get him to third and four.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace it.
Murray now. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. In for the score. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. So that's the rookie's first trip to the end zone, and I think it's safe to say one he'll always remember.
Oh, without a doubt, that one is going to be imprinted forever. And nowadays, we're seeing rookies make a greater impact at that position at receiver than ever before. Yeah. I think mainly because of the sheer volume of footballs that they catch in college.
Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there.
Gosh darn it.
Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside.
Gosh darn it. All right, here we go. 15-10.
They start the drive with Anderson. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
On
it's
going to
be a third hit for CJ Anderson.
And he's taken down at the 43.
Solid.
But not before picking
solid,
up
solid.
The first.
Okay.
9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
They really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions.
First and
the
ten.
Running game starting to come
that's
to the front for them.
Oh, nice
pick up there to keep
that's
this drive going.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but holding the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Back to the ground, Anderson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
On play action, Bradford.
He's got some time. No, he doesn't.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Oh, now we're back on the other side of the field.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pick their back now and get upfield and get after the
game. 2 minute warning.
It's such an impressive first half to get that lead. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend.
Right, 30-20.
To throw is Bradford to the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it. But he is able to keep the feet in
bounds.
They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Oh, that was a terrible punt.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. Second and 10 now from the 27.
All right, here we go, second and 10.
Here we go now.
Let's get some stops. Give us about a minute. Hopefully get us about a
to
minute.
To throw again.
To drive.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
Nice.
8 yards of the completion, but now they face third down.
Oh, third down.
That one in there, able to make connection.
There's a guy up in.
With those faster passes that are going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback, the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception.
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard, your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll be a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
The Cardinals on third down. They've been very good, 5-for-7 thus far. This time it's third and 3.
Let's go.
Operating from the gun. Murray. And able to find Kirk, complete. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. On first down, Murray underneath for Johnson. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that'll make this a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. That one goes for 24 yards. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Back to the air on second down. Murray. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Charles Clay in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Bailey.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about. And still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers.
All right. Bringing Nick Mullins in. Starting quarterback. Shoulders is hurt. That's fantastic. Young. Out for the game. Out for the game. Two quarters. Yeah, I knew he was out. Alright. So let's super send this again.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. Half-time. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided. And now, due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. The Cards with the lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20.
Yeah, 86 yards. That is horrible.
And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. He's going to float this one deep right side. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and they can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That good for 22 and a first down.
So it's pretty simple, partner. You pick up a turnover, you set you up an excellent field position. The last thing you want to do is go three and out in this spot.
They would have to settle for a field goal attempt, but now they keep those touchdown hopes alive. And able to get them inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four.
50 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. The busy night continues for Johnson. Ooh. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Calling a loss of two on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down.
You know it. It's going to be a touchdown.
From the gun, Murray.
Get it.
And he's going to be dropped. Back in the 15-yard line. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field. But they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He was looking to get it to Allen Hurns that time. And that'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, you need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
He goes underneath for Anderson. Bulldozes past him. Nice. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Whether it's what we call an even front or an odd front, and an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense. Odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle. Whether it's the nose or the two defensive tackles in a four-man front, if those guys can't get moved, you cannot run the ball in the middle of the field. But in that play, they were able to actually take care of business.
Handoff comes to Anderson. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now.
Well, there's an example of patience being rewarded. Ran the ball on first down and got stuffed. Most people would scream, throw the ball here in this situation. They stayed with their roots, stayed with running the football, and they got rewarded.
And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play.
Brandon, we're into the second half, and this offense has not scored a lot of points, and that was another example of why. I think it's time to open things up and start really trying to move the ball.
Yes, it is. As we watch another drive, the Arizona Cardinals.
They'll hand it off now. Johnson. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Green 39! Green 39!
Here's a 20th carry for Johnson. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. They lost two there, and it's third down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
No success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, the fans should be applauding this defense right now. It's an excellent job. They force a three and out, and they should be able to set up their guys with great field position, probably near midfield or better.
Oh, that is a beautiful putt.
Big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now we look at C.J. Anderson as he trots back out there and gets set to go on offense. After some early struggles running the ball, they've really picked it up. Early it just seemed like there were no holes there. Now all of a sudden, the holes seem to be there. I don't know if that's just my imagination.
And give them credit. They kept their confidence. Because sometimes when you get stuck big in the running game, early, especially for an entire half, it really makes you retreat a little bit, but not this group. They always have the confidence that they just get their assignments down, they get in sync with their runners, and off they went.
Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And my goodness, that means this next drive will begin 4 yards from the end zone already. Following the penalty, Anderson.
Right, here we go, Anderson.
And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A good comeback there after the penalty, 9 yards, and it's second and 6.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
We got second and 6.
They run with Anderson. He's been the bell cow tonight. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
They'll run it. Here's Anderson. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
All right, here we go. Second and two. Man, this offense is...
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
Going to CJ Anderson.
3 yards there, good enough to keep
yards.
The drive moving.
I think this is the most... I think it's the best rushing game we've had all season.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and ten.
Here we go now.
They run again on first down, Anderson.
I mean, I'm not complaining with all these handoffs at this point. I was earlier.
A nice but one there, 9 yards, and yeah, it'll be second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Yeah, right, here we go. This one, this play.
Carry number 20 up, coming up for Anderson.
Nice.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. Right, he's been decisive.
Maybe
and
another running
been a whole lot of fun to watch.
They'll set nice. Up to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Seals Jones.
He was hurt.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Looking to throw.
That's not CJ Anderson.
And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18.
That shouldn't count as a run.
It's a loss of 2. Now third down. The last catch took him 2 yards in the wrong direction. So now what can they do on third?
This is the moment.
They'll look to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting to drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They're excited about where they are in this game. And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it?
All right, let's see here. Let's go back to Sammy B. Go to the end of the game.
Johnson, and they'll get him down right around the 11-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Not too many more ideal situations in second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
On first and 10, Murray, and completes it to Kirk over the middle. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Back now, just east of Manhattan in Brooklyn. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. They'll run it with Johnson. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Benny Logan in there on the tackle.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A gain of 13 and also the first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate. That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive game. Just keep that clock ticking.
Looking to throw. Murray. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Going with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
One-handed. Love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session if he's saying, hey, run that one back, coach. Yeah. Run that one back.
One more time.
Let's see that
Two
again.
More time.
And they won't.
Eight more times.
They won't. Didn't get much out of it.
All right. We got Bradford back.
A first down throw for Bradford. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll get him down here at the 23. Give him three on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. Working out of the gun, Bradford. That's caught right side by Anderson. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Here's Bradford. It's caught by Davis. And he'll get it down here to the 43. The completion good for three, and it's second down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The reception good for seven. It's third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after.
Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. Shaquille Barrett in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down.
You and I both know we're into a whole new realm of football because we're not just looking at tendencies anymore. We're looking at analytics, and I've got to think the analytics on third and one say run the football.
False start, offense.
So that'll back him up five. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And this is caught. He hits more. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Bradford now to throw on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. A gain of six there on first. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Start offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. The false start hurts him there a bit. Backs him up to second and nine. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
He's going to take a shot for the... And it's caught. Touchdown. As his guys are in for six, and his guys are able to close that gap just a bit. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Are you? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle.
False start, offense.
The offense going to stay on the field as they will line up and go for two. Bradford again. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. So tried to throw it in for 2 points, but the D got home, brought him down.
Yeah, got home, which means there had to be good coverage, just had nowhere to go with the ball. Typically, you try and throw quick hitters, quick slants, you know, maybe even a quick fade. Nothing was open. He ends up getting sacked.
Out comes his field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And it's been a good game for him to this point, Charles. They're winning on the scoreboard. They got to be feeling pretty good.
And it's always fun for them when they're not just winning on the scoreboard, but they're contributing in a big way.
This is Johnson, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12.
But Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, this is my theme of Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. There's Murray. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Pass interference. Defense.
So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Johnson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there, but let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and the big yardage all night long.
Here's Johnson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. I think this defense tired of seeing him run the football, and this D-line probably getting sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about a conversation I had with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asked his running backs each week for their favorite runs. Give me your three top runs. And right now, you're seeing a guy that's probably using his top runs to great advantage in this game.
He is in a zone. A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's extra frustration. Not a good play.
Now Johnson. And a nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line. And Johnson on an island by himself in the backfield. Second and goal.
Yep, on an island. He's going to score.
They'll give it to him up the middle. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Time for a break. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got it third and goal here as they try to finish off their victory. Operating from the gun, Murray. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. In for the score. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is, Is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like him? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Bailey got the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful.
Yep.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Bradford on first down and nearly intercepted. That would have been a hat trick, his third pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Oh man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. Throwing again, Bradford on second and 10. And Davis has it over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
First down, Bradford, quick slant, caught by Moore. And now a fumble, the ball's out. But thankfully, this is corralled by the offense, so they will in fact hold on to the football. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
On first and 10, Bradford over the middle and into the hands of his receiver Moore. And he's taken down inside the 30. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Throwing on first down, Bradford. And that's off the mark, incomplete. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer, just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now, here comes the ball, and he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
On second down, Bradford again. A dump off to Anderson. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a third down. They face a third and 4 after that last completion gets them 6.
No need to look at the score or the stats. We had a win, we lost. Ooh, Justin Coleman. Become 80.
What's it on me? Addicted to balling. I have to give you that. The money is calling. Got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. Flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money. I see how it feels to be rich.
Yeah,
I live by the beach now. That's
Pulling up in that new toy, the wrist on that boy, rock star like Pink Floyd. Waving at rude boy, I'm waving at you, boy. Ran off on the two like True Goy. Imagine me, dude, boy. You could never do what I do, boy. Still ducking that I did, boy. In Paris for a hit, boy. These ain't the same type of hits, boy. Can get, boy. You don't take these type of risks, boy. Cause this boy been throwing that like rich boy. You miss, boy. Your numbers don't add up on the. That was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. Yeah. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of ringing off. I just happen to be alumni. Too legit, they still looking at me with one eye. The company I keep is not corporate enough. Child, you ain't often enough. A rapper turn can morph into us, but a turn rapper can morph into Puff. Dance contest for the I predict Al Roker. If you know, you know. I only ever looked up to you all get a bird, this Oprah. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop like a Walmart. We got the for the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the port, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know. You ever been hit with the water, then had to wait, do you walk away? If you know, you know. When we all clicking like Golden State, and you and your team are the motorcade. If you know, you know. Been granting wishes like a genie to bad in two-piece bikinis.
Yeah,
I've been hiding where you can see me. The skybox is right next to Riri's. Solely responsible for showing rappers how to stand on the front lines when started throwing bands. Where were you when Big brought the Tigers in? Cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball.
Hey everybody, it's the coach and this is Madden Night.
We're about 40 miles south of Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium.
All right, let's go ahead and slow it up to the end of the game.
set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This is taken at the 3. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll be led out by their quarterback standing at 6'2 from Eastern Illinois. It's Jimmy Garoppolo.
I like this guy. And the reason I do, he tends to stand an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. Right back to him on 1st down. Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
More of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
Throwing is Garoppolo on 3rd down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
2 sacks last week, another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
Now, a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. They'll have the former Oklahoma Sooner calling the shots. The quarterback will be Sam Bradford.
And this is a game for grit, determination, and somehow finding a way not to panic. What a horrible start for them. I mean, they haven't won a game yet. So now, as a quarterback, you're not just talking to your team. You've got to demonstrate to them what they need to do to win. He's got to be the leader by how he plays.
False start, offense.
Now they nab the rookie there for the 5-yard penalty.
So much going through his head. You know it just has to be, right? All of his assignments, and realizing every game he plays, one of the better players in the league will be opposite him.
Now Anderson shows off the quick feet as he takes this one up to the 20. Tackle that time by Jarquiski Tart.
All right, Brent, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
They go play action. Now Bradford. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander. And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49ers D as they score the touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's Anderson as they begin this series on the ground.
Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. The play fake, Bradford. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. D Ford not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of nine. They said there was a lot of discussion in their defensive team meeting room after last week's performance. They had seven sacks. Something in the water. There's one in the first quarter.
A lot of discussion, a lot of excitement, because now everyone wants to get involved with this. Who's going to continue that process? Who's going to get to the quarterback this week? But they have to be careful. When you have that much pressure, they want to use it against you. Draws, screens, those types of plays.
We'll see if they do that.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. There's a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
This is Breida. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
This is Coleman. And he'll get three down to the 34-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
From the gun on third, Garoppolo. Ooh, and that is incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And Gould is able to put it through, and that will make it 10-0 here in the first. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
And here now the offense heading back out there. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better.
Drive.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn it into first downs and hopefully points.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. And there are the numbers for C.J. Anderson on the ground last week. 21 carries, 99 yards.
And as we discovered in talking to the coaching staff prior to the game, going up against a team that struggled against the run has only emboldened them to run the football
start,
more.
Offense.
I expect 40 to 50 carries in this game.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. A bad false start penalty there. Now second and six. They'll run it now out of the gun. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. On first down, Bradford, and incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. A look now at the starters on this 49er defense. They played extremely well last week in the win over Atlanta.
I just consider myself fortunate that I'm not in charge of the offensive line. They gave up 7 sacks last week. And if things don't improve in this game, head coach isn't going to be looking at the offensive line. It's going to be looking at the offensive line coach. And that's when things get dicey.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. And incomplete here. So a little razzle-dazzle on that one, but they couldn't hook up, and it's third down. On third down, Bradford. And the Niners get there and bring him down. D. Ford in there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Now a play fake here on first down.
Oh.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
Oop.
And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Give him 14 on the play, and that'll make it third and one.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup And guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. They go play action here on first down. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Nice. Knocking it away there defensively, Justin Coleman.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29.
Nice.
He lost two there, nice. And it's third down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. They saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
A big third down play there for the Niners. 57 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Garoppolo looking very comfortable running this Niners offense. He's got a first and 10. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
There we go, Chase Winovich. There we go.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Throw left side, complete. That's Robbins. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. On that quick throw, what do you think? Possibly something they saw at the line to go there?
Possibly.
Looking to hit Matthews, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Preston Brown, the linebacker. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
Bradford. Screenplay, Anderson. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
Taken right around the 44. Give them 11 yards that time on the return. And the Niners set up well. They take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football. And everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Goodwin able to haul it in. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. A pretty sizable deficit here in the first quarter. This defense will probably need to get off the field in those situations on third down.
And you and I both know in this huddle before that last third down play, that's exactly what they talked about.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
For a rookie first rounder, he's made a huge impact on this defense, but that tells me that they had a plan for him when they drafted him. Just turn him loose, do what you do best, go get the quarterback.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24.
Here we go. By 20!
Is that good? Is that good?
And before they can get settled in here, time expires on the first quarter of action. 10-0 our score. We're back to Santa Clara after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gunn, Charles Davis with you. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Here we go.
To throw is Garoppolo. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Well wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little, and when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate, and in doing so, sent this one off target.
Now they're set up nicely at the 45-yard line after the missed field goal from 55. A first down throw for Bradford. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. Bradford down, a throw on first down. That's complete to his tight end, Seals Jones. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
He finds Hearns left side. Nice. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
On second down, Anderson. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. To throw is Bradford.
that escapes the sand. But now he's swallowed up and taken down. DeForest Buckner, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
They were in the top 5 in sacks in the league coming into this one. That's their third one in this game. Obviously, pass rush has been a strength of this team all year long.
And apparently, they're not satisfied with top 5. They want to climb that ladder.
Yeah, I think it goes back to their offseason. They decided to make it a priority, and it's working out.
That's on the big left tackle, former number 2 overall pick, Greg Robinson. Second down, Bradford. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
And this offense on third down today, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and a mile. Bradford. A bullet throw, but incomplete.